Thank you. I'd like to call up Phyliss Hollow Horn from the Oglala Nation. On that day, on December 29th, the United States 7th Cavalry had our relatives gathered together in a circle. They removed any type of weapons, guns, rifles, and anything that might be a potential threat to them. That included our grandmother's scissors and knives and anything considered metal that could be used as a weapon. Thereby, it ended up our relatives' houses and defenses. This dark stain will not be found in any history books, nor is it being taught in American educational institutions here in the United States. The action and mentality behind all of this still exists today, only as taking new face and form in the new hope of our children through CPS throughout America. Our missing and murdered Indigenous women, the violence against our Native women, and the effects of forced removal during war history days. From all these, we suffer from what is called historical trauma. This is still felt throughout the United States and Canada. Today, we, the lineal descendants of the 1890 Wounded Knee Massacre, as members of the committee and also Congress, to rescind the 20 medals of honor given to the 7th Cavalry, and thus to begin a step towards healing historical and historical trauma, and also to begin the spirit of reconciliation. With that, although my statement is very brief, I want to take the time to thank all those here today, especially today is the 124th anniversary of Phyliss Hollow Horn in our oral history. You know that Wounded Knee, which happened 14 years later, the massacre, is a result of that battle that we won 124 years ago at the Battle of the Horn Racecraft. So with that, I want to say, Wokilatanka, thank you for all those that are here and listening to what we have to say for any of our and our relatives, our grandfathers and great grandfathers. Thank you very much.